It's a great honor for me and for NGMA to have this great show over here. Before we begin, can we start the proceedings with lighting of the lamps? And can I request all the members to please light the lamps? And on Art Musings, can I request Shanti to come and light the lamp, please? May I request Mr. Shiv Prasad Khenid, Director, NGMA, to kindly give his welcome address.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the National Gallery of Modern Art, the Ministry of Culture, the Government of India, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all for the opening of this great exhibition, the Retrospective of Sakti Burman. At the very outset, I would like to welcome the artist himself, who has found time to be with us for the opening of the ceremony, opening ceremony of this exhibition. I would like to welcome the chairman of the advisory committee of the National Gallery of Modern Art, Sri Suhas Bahulkarji. We have representatives from the art museums. Sangeeta ji is here. I think Shanti ji is she's here as well. And of course, the curator of the exhibition, all important person, Ranjit Hoskote. We also have with us a couple of advisory committee members. I can see, of course, Bharatji himself, who is comparing the whole show. And we also have with us Brindaji. I don't know where is she. Brindaji is here. Brindaji. Again, welcome you all to this wonderful exhibition. Incidentally, you know, this happens to be the 70th year of India's independence. You know, it was declared as India-UK year of culture. And perhaps it's the opposite. Chhatrapati Museum is having a great exhibition, India and the World, which is perhaps opening very shortly, maybe in less than a month from now. It's a good and excellent coincidence that during that time, the 70 years of the works of Shaktiji is being exhibited in this retrospective. We are honored that we have this exhibition concurrently when we have another India and the World exhibition there. Initially, when this the concept and the exhibition started, I was really skeptical that the dome, we have a huge area and it looks, if you have four floors and then the huge dome. I was discussing with Sangeeta ji, I said, you're going to have your exhibition up to the fourth floor and then maybe the dome area we'll have our own works that we have. She said, no, we are going to cover this. I was very skeptical until the last couple of days back, maybe about 2 weeks. Now I see that maybe some of the works have not been included. So it's going to be the pleasure for the art connoisseurs who are all here. Thank you again for sparing your time to be with us. And I think this will only be the inauguration, and I'm sure you may not have time to look at it completely. I mean, although Ranjit will find some time to walk through the whole gallery, please do come again and again, and please inform your friends and well-wishers to visit this National Gallery of Modern Art. Thank you again.
Now may I request Shri Suhas Baholkarji, the chairperson of the advisory committee, to come and give his address.
Shaktida and all the lovers of Shaktida's work, National Gallery of Modern Art Advisory Committee, and all the staff members, welcome you. Being associated with NGMA, today I came to NGMA around 4:15. Entered the gallery, and my first reaction was, oh, it's celebration of forms, colors, and cultures. It is also a celebration of artist's life, his devotion, dedication, and creation with patience. You can imagine what a minute work Shaktida does, what a minute and intricate textures he creates. The forms he uses, right from deities to Gandhiji, and a common man to his self-portrait, or a child on his lap. I don't know whether it was his son, it is his son, or his grandson. Oh, I thought that. So it's just a patience. It's just a dedication, and a dedication of life. Dedication towards work, and dedication towards his inner voice. It is through his eyes, mind, soul, and work. The works tell you it can't be anybody else but great Indian artist Sakti Burman. One can always feel that his works are full of joy, hope, and dreams. When you see the works, they're so colorful. They speak to you. They try to tell you something, and that is always hopeful. This whole appear on his canvas in such a manner due to his approach towards life. He expresses it through a variety of forms, which includes human figures, trees, flowers, birds, animals, furniture, curtains, and many more things on this earth. Apart from such objects of daily life around us, Shaktida also encompasses the deities, gods, and goddesses, not only from Hindu religion, but from different religions like Christianity also. In the process, they lose their religious identity and can come together and start playing in his mind and appear on the canvas. It creates an ambience along with a unique colors and textures. It indeed is a treat to the viewer. His creations have a strong link with Indian culture and the life he is experiencing after reaching to Paris in 1956. I'm really amazed to see his beautiful still lives, which he did around 1960, they are here. I mean, I never experienced his such work because I have been seeing his work for the last 30 years. But these old works, that shows the process of an artist, his thinking, his creation, and his experimentation. A section of his works travel as education, a visual record of his formative years to various countries of the world is a unique experience. They are just opposite this wall. The section Parallax Vision is just amazing. It's on the right hand side. I'm sure this exhibition is going to be a treat for artists, art lovers, students, and visitors to NGMA. His paintings, Le Dejur or Taj Mahal, is a unique example of his imagery and his approach. He also titled it as Homage to Manet. But it is also a homage to Shah Jahan and his creation Taj Mahal. It is also a homage to Shah Jahan's love for Mumtaz Begum. And Sakti Burman combines it with the present generation also, thus it becomes a celebration. The most touchy part of this exhibition is the artist as collector and the birthday greetings. They are on the fourth level. I think these personal anecdotes really enriches this exhibition. My congratulations to Shaktida. He's 82, but see the energy. I left maths when I was in school. No. But at the age of 84, he's so energetic. He not only works hard, but he travels a lot. He meets people. He enjoys meeting people. And he remembers whosoever he met, because he met me about 8 months back. And today he remembered the moment that I was curating the exhibition of Bombay Art Society. My congratulations and regards to Shaktida's wife and family. And of course, the congratulations to Art Musing, Shanti ji, Sangeeta, and Kasturi ji. This exhibition is really a unique example of the relationship between the art gallery and the artist. And lastly, Ranjit, you have done a great job. You have given us a treat. And especially the text panels, I request you to read. They really throw a light to the, not only to the paintings, but towards the approach of the artist and the thoughts behind the paintings. Thank you.
Before I invite Sangeeta to address on behalf of Art Musings, I'll just take the liberty of saying a few words. I have known her for the last 26, 27 years, and transition from fashion to the world of art has really been amazing. And she is a sort of mentor for me. I'm also an artist, so she's a mentor for me for all my exhibitions, and she's just remarkable. The way she conceptualizes and she puts the things is just amazing, and we are really honored that the way this exhibition has been put up over here. So it's thanks a lot, Sangeeta, for helping me as well as putting up such a great show in NGMA. Thank you. Can I ask you to please come and speak for us?
Good evening, friends, and thank you all for being here this evening with us. It is an honor for us at Art Musings to be presenting this monumental exhibition, a retrospective of Sakti Burman, which has been masterly curated by Ranjit Hoskote here at this most prestigious, the National Gallery of Modern Art. I would like to thank the Ministry of Culture, Government of India for the support that they have extended to us. I would also like to thank the director, NGMA, Mr. Shiv Prasad Kened, Mr. George D'Souza, Mr. M. Shankar, Ms. Shruti Das, all the members of the advisory committee and its chairperson, Mr. Suhas Bahulkar. Thank you, Dada. An exhibition of this scale and magnitude would not have been envisaged at any other space. I'm going to take the liberty to quote from Ranjit's curatorial text. Private museums may come and go, but public institutions carry the precious mandate of our collective memory. Ranjit's vision has always been vast and all-encompassing, and yet again he has brought to this project depth and finesse. Ranjit, thank you for everything. This has been and continues to be an amazing experience. This retrospect would have not been possible were it not for the artist's wife, Maithi Deltel. It started in Spain in the summer of 1959. Since then, she has painstakingly collected drawings, photos, sketchbooks, paintings, and kept them away. And these all form an integral part of this exhibition here. I want to thank all the collectors who have so generously loaned their work to this major museum exhibition. And lastly, I want to say a big thank you to the artist himself. 6.5 decades of devoted practice, a treasure for all the art lovers, Dada. At 84, you're going strong and a big inspiration. Thank you for this privilege and pleasure. Thank you, everybody.
I would like to invite the curator, Mr. Ranjit Hoskote, to say a few words. And I think this is his 8th or 9th show in NGMA. So the association has been quite long. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Bharat. It's very kind of you to recall that. And thank you all for coming out in such large numbers in an evening where family, religion, and other preoccupations might have made a claim on your time. And I have to say that I am somewhat overcome by emotion on this occasion for several reasons. I'm going to try and be brief, which is what speakers say to you when they're about to hold forth for about 20 minutes, but I won't. As Bharat said, this is the 8th exhibition that I've had the privilege of curating within the NGMA